Question, what is our base out for Newton shuttle per centimeter square?
Going back the other way.
And then finally a slightly harder one,
is it only give me half a
second? 13 minutes to be on the other side, because that's what we have to do. Calculator,
this left again,
13 minutes.
Now my outer is 8.5
centimeters. We've got to divide one of these
centimeters.
We're going to give it 8.
My diameter is 8.
We're going to go circumference.
Centimeters,
so if he lives,
that rounds up to 8.5.
Another thing that I might ask you to convert,
take away 1.2
not 10 volume,
put that in
the centimeters cubed
to liters,
which now we arrive at an important fact.
In another chart, we might get 62.8, which is something that looks like this. Times 5 centimeters. With simultaneous equations, which is a bit of a work.
Now, this is the area that actually comes
along yesterday. So that's where we're going to leave this one.
So if you want to know the engine size, you can actually measure it.
So this example is going
to
have,
I can say I don't need to do anything. It's already given me the radius.
2 liter engine, 2 centimeters.
The area of the inner circle is going to be 5,000, so that will be a 2,000 cc engine.
A trick one is 2 liters.
Next, I'm going to
2 liters for an 8,000 centimeters.
So calculator
5.
And we're going
to get to 12
6.
I've done these around the wrong way. converting from milliliters to centimeters. Those two things are very much the same thing. So 3 milliliters is the same thing.
How is
3 centimeters cubed? Going back to my ideas, if we have some units on there.
Before I do that, I should be good.
This one's going to go meters across through this one because 30 meters across the room. I ran out of room on my wife.
My ideas
is going to be how many.
I'm going to say,
I'm going to look for a number that's halfway between 20 and 30. Halfway between 20 and 30 is going to be
12.3566 centimeters squared.
So there's going to be 7
by the height. Again, we're going to biff that in the calculator and see what happens.
I'm going to take this fella.
25 times 2 is 50. So move it to that side.
Meters a minus 0.
Because any area is going to be measured in either centimeters squared, meters squared, or kilometers squared.
Centimeters squared.
No, and I'm going to do one more example, which requires a calculator, essentially. Maybe you could do this in your head.
That's why I should do things in steps.
Don't think I could.
Steps instead of trying to rush.
So... We're just going to plug some numbers into the formula, plug them into our calculator, and see
1.25 take away 0.1 is 1.15x.
It's actually probably not that hard to find a number between 13.2 and 14.5, but I'm lazy, so I'm just going to shove some numbers into
it. I'm going to move the 20 to the other side. 20 on one side becomes a minus 20 on the other side. 40 take away 20 is 20.
And I'm going to times that by 33. So I'm going to be left with, when we chuck stuff into our calculator, we're going to ignore the units, the kilometers, and we're just going to deal with the numbers.
Put that into
our calculator, a half, I get 17.39. So we were pretty close,
13.2,
not
plus
14.5 times 33, and we get 457.05.
That's not 17 kilometers.
And we're going to put some units on this. There's no way you can measure it in kilometers, so our area must be measured in kilometers.
We've got one more intersection point to find, which is the intersection between Euler's e-bikes and our bus. Luckily, this one's not too bad, because the equation for the bus is just 45.
So there's one less thing that we have to move around from one side to the other.
So if y is 0.1x plus 40, and y is interchangeable with 45, then 45 equals 0.1x plus 40.
Now I've only got 1x, don't have to do anything with that yet. I just want these two numbers to be on the same side because they like each other. So I'm going to move the 40 to the other side. Plus 40, when you move it across the equal sign, becomes a minus 40. 45 take away 40 is 5. Then I want to get x out here on his own. It's got a 0.1 next to it, so I'm going to move the 0.1 to the other side. It becomes divided by 0.1. Five divided by 0.1. I don't need my calculator for that. Well, partly because I already know it's going to work out to be 50.